Well, I'm out in the barnyard here this morning, and I have decided that I'm going to put my hay conveyor back together, and I'm going to make some square bales, small square bales out of second crop here, and put them in the barn. I have enough round bales. No matter what I do next, I've got enough round bales to feed the cows. I'm probably going to cut back my beef herd a little bit. depending on a few other things, I might cut it back quite a bit, but we'll see. And hay seems to be bringing pretty good money around here. At least people are asking good money for hay. I'm not sure if they're getting it, but at any rate, I plan to bale several loads of small square bales, put them in the hay mow. This will be second cutting, and of course it will be certified organic, so I can get them in the hay mow and take my time and advertise them and sell them as I can. So I need to get the lower part of this hay conveyor out of the hay mow and set it up here, put it together, and string the chain back through it. My former business partner and I used to just kind of manhandle that around and do that when it came to putting it up and taking it down. But yeah, I think I'm pretty sure the skid steer is going to be involved in this operation today. So let's get busy and see what we can do. Well, so far so good. This wasn't as bad as I had remembered, mainly because once I started digging it out, I remembered that I had robbed the electric motor off this a few years ago to put on my cement mixer. So this is lighter than it was when we were manhandling this around a few years ago. Let's see, I sold my dairy cows in March of 2014, so the last time this thing was together and in use would have been the summer of 2013, so 6 years ago. So so far so good. I'll have to get a ladder out and get up on the milk house roof, and there are 6 3/8 bolts to bolt this thing together up there. So I'll see if I can get that done without injuring myself. Okay, I got this upper end hoisted up into place with a rope and got it all bolted together. So now I need to get this chain all sorted out and threaded down through the lower end of the elevator. So yeah, I need to tighten up my chain on that big conveyor a little bit. Okay, well, I thought I'd give you a little closer look at the 90-degree corner up here in the barn. And yeah, I'm on a ladder up here. I still have a few conventional straw bales and a few conventional hay bales here. I need to move to another part of the barn before I start putting the organic hay in. But anyway, I was up here oiling the chains, and I don't know if you've never seen one of these 90-degree corners in action. It's got the rollers on the end of each one of these slats, runs in a track, and it just kind of pulls it around, and the bolts that stick up grab the bale, and it pulls it around here and drops it onto this other conveyor, and down it goes to the kickoff. But when I came up here to oil this just now, I I seen this, and I did kind of remember that I've got a broken link right there on this, so I need to back off these adjusters, pull this up around, and put a different link in it. I think it's just a number 55 flat chain, if I remember right. But I need to do that before I start getting hay in, but I'm not sure I'm going to do that today. I might just let that wait for another day. All right, the bottom part of the conveyor here is working pretty smoothly. The chain is still pretty tight. I put some oil on it and I'm letting it run for a while. I imagine after the rust gets worn off, it'll loosen up a little bit, but that's okay. The 90 degree corner up there works pretty good. There are two things you need to remember. You need to put the bales on the elevator and make sure they're straight, because if they're, you know, cocked off sideways, they'll hang up on the corner up there. And you need to make sure there are about there's about 4 feet in between each bale, because even though this part of the conveyor and the upper part of the conveyor run at the same speed, the bales will slow down as they go around the corner. So if you put them too close together, they'll bunch up up on top there, and that won't be good. I've had pretty good luck when I'm unloading it, but usually I'm the one baling hay, and it seems that those two rules were always challenging for the kids we had unloading hay. So I guess it's human nature to want to unload the hay loads as fast as you can. But anyway, I'm anticipating it'll work pretty good for me. So it looks like there's not going to be much hay weather on tap for the next week or so. But whenever it does get fit to put up some hay, I'll make some square bales and run them in the barn here with the conveyor. So when that happens, I'll get some video of that. But until then, have a good day. Step when the hurdy-gurdy man came singing songs of love.